Mike, the Phillies just drove me crazy in their series against the Giants. They lose the series. I knew it was going to be a tough one because of the pitching matchup. Giants have some very good pitchers. But the funniest thing was Saturday night we're watching the game in the sports office, and Dan Massey, one of our crew, got that upset. He turned and went back to his computer and checked his pulse. Now, he's a runner, too. I thought, Dan, do I need to go get some CPR people here?
It's not he should not be a high blood pressure guy.
That's what happens when you leave 11 men on base, and they did that
all. It was a really, really tense series and a tense game six. There's no question about that. And the bottom line in this Phillies team is they didn't hit the way we think they should have. The way the collective reputation of these players is, they should have been a better offensive team than they were. And that was true throughout the year. That was true when they were healthy.
Yeah.
And it was certainly true in the playoffs.
Yeah, they weren't healthy that often, but when they were, these guys did not hit. You know, they were not who we thought they were.
There you go.
They had good pitching, and they went out and acquired that. And I give Amaro credit for Ruben Amaro for saying, hey, we got to get one more. That's a win in the postseason, but you got to hit some. Too many guys in scoring position didn't get knocked in. But I think it was some fundamentals. Shane Victorino getting picked off bases. You had the situation where we just couldn't advance runners. All you have to do sometimes is move that runner from second to third or from first to second to knock him in. This team tries to hit the three-run home run too much, in my opinion.
Well, I guess. I mean, you look at the series that Ryan Howard had. He hit for a pretty good average, but he didn't drive the ball at all. He did not look like he was trying to hit the home run. But there were some times when they, single or a double, sacrifice fly. I mean, they did get some runs that way. But not enough, and they had some terrible at bats in key situations and the kind of thing that you're talking about. But you know what? I just think it's just that they didn't hit enough. I don't think it's. I mean, people. Every baseball team, every modern baseball team, everybody says they don't situationally hit good enough. I've got emails from people who said that these Phillies aren't as good as the Phillies in the 70s because the Phillies in the 70s were better at situational hitting. Well, I'll guarantee you that the same people were saying the Phillies in the 70s were lousy at situational hitting. They didn't hit enough.
Who do they keep? What happens in the offseason? What do you see?
Well, I would really like to see them keep Jason Worth, who is the key sort of swing guy here. And I think it's possible for them to do that. What I would do, and this may be seen as sort of radical, but I would deal Raul Ibanez for pretty much whatever you could get as long as the team that gets him is willing to take some of his salary. And then I would try to sign Jason Worth and go with Dominic Brown, Victorino, and Worth as your outfield. I think that's doable, but I don't think they're going to think in those terms. I think they have a problem with the length of contract that Worth probably wants, and I know that they have a problem with Scott Boras being his agent, and that's going to make things a lot more difficult.
I think it's an interesting plan on your part. I don't know if Ibanez's contract does enough or they can get enough takers. Shane Victorino being traded might be the difference.
Well, they're not gonna go dollar for dollar. I mean, they're not gonna save enough on Victorino on Ibanez to pay for Worth. But I mean, I'm just talking about minimizing the extra cost.
Worth is a key. You saw what he did in the playoffs with the defense: a diving catch, a great throw out of third base in San Francisco. His ability to hit since 1995 in the National League, he leads in the postseason with home runs, 13. I mean, you got Chipper Jones in there, you got Pujols in there, Jason Worth. I mean, the guy on the right hand side, what he does. It's a key loss if they have him. I think he's going to walk. And I don't think Dominic Brown's going to be enough as a rookie to handle that position both full time. So you're going to have to go out and sign somebody. I'm thinking maybe Xavier Nady, who came off an injury, Tommy John surgery the second time.
That's a name that people have talked about.
2008, he played for the Pirates, had a very good year, and got traded to the Yankees midway through the season. Very good season. Then he got injured, was with the Cubs last year. I think he'd probably come on the cheap, and he crushes the ball with left-hander. So could see him come in here. Don't know if that's as good or not. I still think you really want to make a run, the window's closing, you get a different manager in here. You can go hard-ass now on these guys and get somebody that's going to teach them the fundamentals because, quite frankly, they lack the baseball one-on-one skills that you need in the postseason. A baseball manager, I don't think, wins you lots of games, but he can lose them. In the crucial situations like Saturday night, I knew when that game was 2-2 and it kept getting later, the Phillies were going to find a way to lose that game because their manager would do something stupid in the game. Like letting Ryan Madsen, who pitched two innings, had done it all year, pitched two innings and needed one more out, didn't get through it. You know, those kind of things that happen.
Well, whether you're right or wrong, it's not going to happen. Charlie's going to be back next year for sure. But I think that the Phillies are still going to think of themselves as a major player. They're still going to think about they're not going to go into rebuilding mode. They're not going to go into cost cutting mode. They're about 40, close to $50 million under the salary luxury tax threshold. And there's a level at which it's more cost effective to try to make the playoffs than to not make the playoffs. If your payroll is $150 million and you make it, and it's $140 million and you don't make it, then that's not financially sound either. So I think there's still players, and it'll be interesting to see how this winter plays out. I think if you're a Phillies fan, you're just really disappointed.